you ever fallen on your backside? It can be pretty painful, right? Today, let's talk about the biggest trap that people can fall into, which is even more painful. But the great news is that it costs you absolutely nothing to avoid it, and it is the biggest factor in you feeling more happy and fulfilled. Want to know what it is? Stay tuned. Welcome back to Up It and the Actionables podcast. My name is Peyton. I'm a performance life coach. Before we get into things, a gentle reminder, be sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon so you get notified every time we bring you videos like this that can help you move toward your life goals. Amidst everything that's going on right now, to feel happy and fulfilled might sound a bit of a reach. Or does it really? In one of our recent videos, we spoke about how to handle a difficult situation. Be sure to check that out after you're done watching this one. Okay, so the topic of happiness and fulfillment. What really blows my mind is that most people do things that are counterintuitive to their happiness. Like, can you imagine? Here are a few examples of what people do even though they say they want to be happier. Okay. Number one, worrying about things that have happened and blaming themselves or others. Number two, being jealous of someone else's success. Like as though success was limited and only few people had access to it. Number three, being anxious about what's happening in the world or what could potentially happen. Completely missing the present. And number four, the biggest trap of all that most people fall into is setting goals and waiting to reach them. Say what now? Here's how one may fall into this trap. It happens in three levels. Level one, people set goals because setting goals is the easiest thing to do. My 12-year-old niece sets goals. So no biggie in that, right? Second level is people start to pursue their goals. Fantastic, right? Camera high five. Third level is where it happens. They wait to reach their goals. And then they wait some more and some more. You get the idea. And they literally don't stop to smell the roses. Such people who set goals and wait to reach that goal before they feel a sense of happiness and fulfillment are actually robbing themselves of their present. For a future that may or may not happen. They become so negatively obsessed with their goals that they completely lose focus of what is happening in the world right now. Obviously, I'm not saying that you should not be focused and chase your goals, but the trouble is when someone becomes negatively obsessed and believes that only once they reach their goals will they be happy, that is where the trap lies. And that is something that you need to avoid for yourself. This trap is the biggest reason why some people, even though they may achieve their goals, may end up feeling a deep sense of unfulfillment. Even though their goals may manifest and they may reach them, they may end up feeling empty and hollow. Now I'm going to assume that you may think that why bother setting goals at all? And you may want to avoid setting goals altogether. But then you may fall into another trap, which is you may seek happiness outside and make some materialistic thing, person, object as your source of happiness. Now, the trap to be avoided is you don't really need to reach your goals to start feeling happy and fulfilled. I know how counterintuitive that may sound, but the understanding that needs to happen is the pursuit of goals in itself should make you feel happy and content. And reaching the destination and your goals is an additional bonus. Stop waiting to be in a better physical shape or to meet the right person or to earn money or even for the COVID cure to come out. Your happiness lies within you. Your pursuit of goals is enough in order for you to feel happy and fulfilled. Because nothing external is ever going to give you that sense of accomplishment. That sense of accomplishment, fulfillment, joy, happiness comes from within you. It comes from the meaning that you associate with your experiences. So any experience that you're having in life, be careful about what meaning you're relating to it. The meaning that you give to your experiences will ultimately determine how happy and how fulfilled you feel in life. So set goals, be ambitious, but don't postpone your happiness. Happiness is not a destination. And don't put a condition on being happy. Life is not an if-then flowchart. So in the end, the question really is, why even bother setting goals when you may end up falling into this trap? Because setting goals gives your life a sense of direction and purpose. But the understanding and awareness that needs to happen is, don't rely on reaching that goal to feel ultimately happy. Be happy and be present right now. So in the words of Mihaly Csikszentmihalyi, I can't pronounce his surname with no disrespect, but the author of Flow, in his words, this is what he says about happiness. Happiness is not something that happens. It's not the result of good fortune or random chance. It is not something that money can buy or power command. It does not depend on outside events, but rather on how we interpret them. Happiness, in fact, is a condition that must be prepared for, cultivated, and defended privately by each person. So I hope this episode helped. If you like it, share it with a friend, subscribe, and I will see you next week. If you'd like to get in touch with me, hit me up on social. My handle on Instagram is @BaitinsLife. For personalized help with your life goals, check out my company on upitaway.com. Till next week, remember, what you want matters, and it's really up to you to make it happen. Stay healthy, stay safe. I'll talk to you soon. See ya.